please don't let me be moved into anointing to do what I'm not called to do. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a round of applause for brother Benga Uweye Weiss. Amen. The Lord is good. And all the time. See, that's why they say you need to discover what your gift is so that you'll be able to use it appropriately in the house of God. See, like that lady, she likes to talk in the house of the Lord. Amen. That's why she's talking. Hallelujah. That is one of the gifts. She can sing and talk at the same time. It is a special talent. Give her a round of applause. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Somebody is going to go home with this CD. Now, when Brother Agbenga was telling you about this CD, he said, it's not begging you to buy this CD. But let me tell you something. We move and we market in different ways. I came with CD. I am begging you to buy that CD. Because you're not buying it will mean that I will go home by road. And I live in Los Angeles, California. And that means I will not be home until next week. So I am begging you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I came with CD on Agubayo. It's called Gospel According to Comedy. It's out there, in fact. Please start doing it like they do in traffic. Buy your CD. Buy your CD right now. How many of you made it like? There's nothing you cannot buy in Lagos traffic. If you are stuck in traffic, you can buy pot, stove, and start cooking. Buy meat, buy tomato, onion, everything. Before you get home, you can never be hungry. Start cooking in your car. And how many of you know that in Lagos traffic, they know the specific thing to sell to you because they meet your specific need. They look at your car and they sell what your car needs. Like when they look at your car and they see that it's around Volkswagen, you don't say, buy your rat poison, rat poison, rat poison. Buy rat poison, rat killer. Air freshener, air freshener, air freshener. That's how one husband and wife, they were fighting in the middle. I will kill you, I will wound you, I will kill you. Don't get buy your cutlass, buy your cutlass. Kill your husband, kill your husband. Kill him, kill him, kill him, cutlass, kill him. Lagos traffic, they have specific things for your need. Things that specify your need, amen. Hallelujah. Now, before we call on the next church, I want to bring something to your attention. This is very important. I want you to be in the spirit. Like I said earlier on, God is a spirit. And those who worship Him, worship in the spirit and in. Now, have you noticed that when men of God quote the Bible, you can easily know us who are beginners and men of God who are veterans by the way they quote the Bible. I will give you an example. Now, when you see maybe our Papa and the Lord, or veteran men of God, when they quote the Bible for you, they quote it verbatim even while you're still trying to open your Bible, you're trying to Google it. This is what they do. Brethren, open your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 3, verse 16. While you're still trying to open your Bible, you just hear them quote, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in Him would not perish but have everlasting life. When you open your Bible, you just read it like that, word for word. I did it intentionally. I use it as an example. I want to know who go to Bible class here. It's a test. It was only here that they knew. You guys were just smiling. You didn't know. Now you're trying to make me look like I made a mistake. I didn't. It was a trap for you. Now, when you see us beginners, when we quote those kind of Bible verses, this is what you hear. Brethren, can somebody open your book to the book of Matthew 7:7? You will not see. Oh, yeah, what does he say? You now hear, ask and it shall be asked and it shall be given. Given. Marakiki mama sitting. Then what happened after that? Seek and you shall find. What happened after that? Knock and it shall be open. Then what happened after that? We don't even know when they are finished. It's finished. It is. Oh, it's finished. Okay, all right. People were laughing at me. But I want you to know that everything is in the spirit. I remember one time in Lagos, one of our pastors was preaching about Jonah and the fish. And he was led by the spirit. And he said, and Jonah swallowed the fish. And I said, no, pastor, it was not Jonah that swallowed the fish. It was the fish that swallowed Jonah. Pastor just went, whether Jonah swallowed the fish or the fish swallowed Jonah, all I know that Jah was a swallow. Turn to your neighbor, say swallow. Amen. The Lord is good. All the time. Those of you who have been laughing at me, whether it is Matthew 3:16 or John 7:7, it is in the Bible. Amen. 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 If you have been blessed by today's ministration, just give the Lord a big round of applause. Give the Lord a clap offering. Keep clapping. If you know that you have been blessed by the music ministration, by the drummers, by the singers, by the dancers, give the Lord a clap offering. Make some joyful noise unto the Lord. To do the vote of thanks, and our Father and the Lord will round it up with prayers, and we'll go to our different homes, and we know that our doors of opportunities has been opened. So today will mark the beginning of a new day in our life, the turning point for good things in our life. We shall give testimonies. Pregnant women shall come with babies. Those who are looking out to God for the fruit of the womb, they shall deliver the fruit. Those who are looking for husband, they will see their husband. Those who are looking for wife, will see their wife. Those who are looking for the fruit of the road in cars, they will see the fruit. Amen. Those who are looking for the fruit of the bedroom, they will see it. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Vote of thanks.